grazing obviously changes the species composition. So some trees, for example, will be eaten and others won't. But it also very much changes the structure of the habitat. So for example, this is a piece of hawthorn I bought from outside in an ungrazed area. And you can see all this floppy vegetation. And if then you graze the outside where the apical meristems are, then that will mean that the other meristems will start growing and branching. So here is a piece we've just extracted from this bit of hawthorn, and you can see how thick and impenetrable it is, and how it's got more thorns, and how much denser it is. So we're here at Knepp, and there's the paradox that there's a high density of predators, stoats and foxes, five species of owls, and yet there's a very high density of nesting birds nesting in these bushes. And the suggestion of Isabella Tree and Charlie Burrell is that it's this change in structure resulting from the grazing that means that birds can nest in here and not be predated because it's so thick and dense. And that seems a plausible, if untested, idea. And this seems to be really open for a research project to compare the breeding success of birds nesting in grazed bushes compared to those nesting in ungrazed bushes.